My parents divorced when I was 10 years old. As overcompensation for my father leaving, my mother let me see Raiders of the Lost Ark 30 times in the theater, and she saw it with me 12 of those times. And because of that, she and I would reference that movie often. For instance, if either of us ever got something that we wanted, held on to it for just a moment, but then fate ultimately took it away, we would quote the scene where Indiana Jones is in his classroom talking to Marcus Brody, telling him how he had just lost the golden idol to Belloc, and he says,
"I had it, Marcus. I had it in my hand."
So, there was this one time. A few years back, I was sitting in a small theater in Hollywood watching former students of mine perform in a sketch comedy show, and sitting directly in front of me was Harrison Ford. This was absolutely thrilling for me, and I couldn't believe my luck. I mean, I've watched this guy so many times throughout my life that I've even taken on certain mannerisms of his. Like, for instance, he has a specific type of smile that he does, which is the left side of his mouth goes up, he exhales, then the rest of the face follows. So, after the show, I was standing in the crowded lobby, and Harrison Ford's about 20 feet away from me, and when I realized who he had come to see, I exclaimed out loud to no one in particular, "Oh my God, it's Joan. I was her favorite teacher." And then I bolted down the hallway, pushing people out of the way until I reached them. And when I did, Joan exclaimed, "Kevin, I want you to meet my godfather, Harrison Ford." Harrison Ford stuck out his hand. I put mine out, took it, and we shook hands. And his grip was firm and kind. Other family members approached us, so our time was cut short, so I quietly made my way to the side and pretended to play with my phone. After a few minutes, Harrison Ford parted ways from the group and started making his way towards the stairs and the exit, alone. I caught up to him halfway down the stairs, and I nervously stammered that he had been such an influence in my life, and that my parents divorced the year that Raiders came out, and that for a lonely kid going through a sad time, this movie brought me a tremendous amount of happiness. And as someone who's been inundated by fandom his entire life, he said nothing at first. And I said, "I'm not the first one to say something like that to you, am I?" And he looked at me and he said, "No, you're not." We parted ways at the bottom of the stairs, and I wished I had had more time to actually talk to him, but at least I got to meet him and see that smile. I got in my car and drove away that night thinking that my encounter with Harrison Ford could not have gone better. And then I went and did a stupid improv show in NoHo. And why I say stupid improv show in NoHo is because the next morning I ran into another one of Joan's castmates who said to me, "Kevin, where were you last night? Harrison Ford decided to take us all out for drinks and we were looking to invite you. I got to talk to him for like 15 minutes. I had it, Marcus. I had it in my hand. Ha 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 ha!